Push P. Yeah, Push P, turn me up.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to my new video. Today, you can see, last night, I just started some new exercises, but after looking at it, 150 exercises, and you know, I just wasn't gonna do all of them. I don't wanna go from tutorial to tutorial. I'm gonna go back to the main one that I couldn't pass. I'm gonna go here, this is it. The strategy right now, for example, off the bat. So here we're supposed to use the reduce method, which I don't understand. And then I'm looking at the instruction here. We're supposed to use filter and the map and then the reduce, or just use all three of them. But the main thing they're trying to teach you here is the reduce. I remember using the filter, but I don't remember what exactly. So the strategy is to, I opened up three web pages. I Googled filter method for JavaScript, and then I opened up three things right here. So I'm gonna open up as much as I need to. If I need to open up more, like different pages and whatnot, just to learn, I'm gonna do it. That's the strategy going forward, instead of going back and relearning what I already know. I already know the basics. Let's just jump to it, bro. Like, you know. So for example, right here, let's see. Normally I take my time. You know how I am. I read slow because I like to, I like it, you know, in here. So see, the filter array method creates a new array with elements that fall under a given criteria from the existing array. You'll learn about the filter array method. So this is for arrays, apparently. It's not for, I thought it was for other things, but I don't know. For objects. The syntax for filter resembles, so whatever array you have, you're gonna filter it, use a function. Okay, so you're gonna create a new array. This is what I, this is where I get stuck. I try to understand this. So whatever array you have, so let's say this is, so numbers dot filter, and whatever function, the item argument is a reference to the current element in the array as filter, checks it against the condition. Okay, if I understand correctly, I'm gonna go ahead and create, for example, this one. Numbers, I like to mess with it. This is how I learn. This is how I hope to learn. If not, I'll change up the strategy. You don't need that. I just learned you don't need a semicolon. It's recommended, but you don't need one. That's why I was wondering in the editor, why doesn't it automatically add a semicolon? You don't need it. All right, so we can name a new array. New array, numbers dot filter. As for the function, no name, I'm gonna leave it like that. Function parameter, see, that's the theme, bro. What do you mean? Oh, this is where I don't get it. Okay, so function and return n greater than 6. Is this like a for loop? That's what I'm thinking right now. I think it's like a for loop, right? Let's go ahead and, it's in a console.log, a new array. Let's see, console. A new array, like of new, you know. No. Console.log, new array, no. What's going on here? New array, what did I do? Did I do something wrong or something? Console.log, shell. Check on everything. Document.write. I don't have it connected to the HTML, so I don't know if it's gonna work. Let's see. doesn't work. All right, so some troubleshooting here. Let's see. Okay, what's on? Do I actually need the? What's going on? All right, I opened up a new one. We'll see how this one console. There we go. All right, let's see if it works out. All right, let me just make sure I understand it. Why is this? Oh, maybe that's why it wasn't working. Forgot the comma. All right, let's see, everything good. Okay, so from my understanding, the function, it doesn't have a name. It's just an anonymous function. It's gonna filter if n is greater than 6. Okay, it's gonna make a new array. So it's like a for loop. That's weird, bro. Except instead of making a list, like instead of doing this, or not a list, I get used to Python, but instead of making an empty array, for loop, pushing it, it's just straight up a new array. I want to know the limits though. What are the limits? Because I've seen it used in a different way. I've seen it used in many ways. Okay. So yeah, I mean, that's pretty much it for today. Just going to be doing this until it fully, well, not fully penetrates my brain, but like until I get it, just enough. Because I was kind of like, damn, am I really going to have to do 150? So I started Googling on Reddit, usually what I do. How did you learn JavaScript? And then a bunch of people kept saying that they've been doing it for years and they still don't understand it. So I was like, I'm not sure I want to do Java. I'm not sure I want to do exercises for like 5 years and then create a website. Like, I want to, you know, learn. You just got to do the hard work. That's all it is. Thank you guys for watching. Peace out.
Even if you are not ready for the day, it cannot always be night.